There's 14,000 cups of coffee drank every second globally. And the coffee business is becoming very high-end. We pay $4, $5, $10 for a cup of coffee, but really the price to the farmer hasn't changed. The fair trade system often isn't applied fairly, honestly, to the farmers that produce the goods. So at Becks 360, we're really trying to give a clear picture of what impact your purchase at a coffee shop will have on the people that actually produce that coffee. So we've developed a technology that incorporates machine vision, artificial intelligence, and blockchain payments to bring the largest unautomated system in the world to modern technology. Like most people on the planet, coffee, it is just a part of my morning routine. Let's go, come on. These are some that my girlfriend brought back from Rwanda recently. The things I love about coffee is just kind of knowing the story where the coffee came from. I can picture where the hard work's being done to harvest this, and it's also providing me with something that I really enjoy every morning. I'm Dan Jones, I'm the CEO and founder of Becks 360. This is our Becks cup my daughter made. My passion is really with technology and the developing world, trying to think of ways that technology can really have an impact. I lived in Congo from 2008 through 2015, and one of the projects that we worked on was a conflict-free sourcing initiative for minerals in eastern Congo. We actually built a small robot that could do the analysis of minerals at the point of collection. And what we found was that the artisanal miners almost trusted the machine more than they trusted people in some senses, because a lot of these economies are very corrupt, and they really would like to see a digital readout of what the quality of their minerals were. So we started to think of how could we marry that with technologies that are being developed for artificial intelligence, for blockchains. So all of that kind of infrastructure made it possible to really automate these antiquated supply chains. And that's why we started Becks 360. The blockchain is a really amazing technology that can serve in many realms, especially in the developing world. When many people think of the blockchain, they think of Bitcoin.
Bitcoin is just kind of the first implementation of blockchain technology.
Blockchain really is a system in which transactions are recorded globally across the whole network, tens of thousands potentially of servers, so there's an immutable record that transaction occurred. Our team started thinking about how we could expand that type of technology to other commodities. And coffee was just a natural fit. About 1 in 60 people get their livelihood because of the coffee supply chain. 25 million directly and 100 million indirectly. And they feed this massive system of coffee drinkers all over the world. At Becks 360, we're focused on this idea of conscious consumerism. Consumers themselves want to know the social impact they have, but there really is no system in place to ensure the consumer that the coffee that you're purchasing actually doesn't have a negative impact on the farmers themselves. So we're really focused on implementing technologies that can improve how we source and provide traceability for these critical products that come from the developing world. The blockchain provides a level of truth that's above most systems that are in place today. It can give you that record, which can never be changed. Welcome to Becks 360. I'm going to show you the process of why we're building the robots we're building. We've developed a small robot that could do the analysis of coffee at the point of collection. If you were harvesting these in Nicaragua or in Congo or in Uganda, you would harvest about 30 kilograms of these a day. So what we're analyzing with our robot, and we can go take a look at it, is we're basically, as a farmer, you would come to our collection center where our robot is, you would place your goods in this hopper. So what our system does is it images every single coffee cherry. We're looking for the size, color, and ultimately we're trying to be able to do density as well. It determines the quality of that coffee. And then based upon that, we tell them what the price it is we're going to pay them. As soon as they agree to sell their coffee using our machine, then we'd make a digital payment using the blockchain immediately to them. It immediately pays not only them, but the owner of the machine, the bank, the co-op, landowner, taxes, whatever it needs to do. And it does that using the blockchain The other piece is giving immediate feedback to the farmer themselves. So we can say, these are when you should pick your fruit. This is the point where they're worth the most. They can really focus on the highest value products as it enters the supply chain.
You're doing great.
You're square on my side. Now we have it mobile. So we're ready to take it and put it in a trailer and take it out to California and put it in the coffee farms out there so we can actually test it in the field with live cherries and live green coffee. So we're here today to really increase the efficiency of the machine.
How soon can you do parchment?
By this time next year, at least, or in the spring, we'll be able to sort whatever attributes you really want.
We're trying to develop this transparency so that people at every point of the supply chain can know the impact that they have on the world through their purchases. We can then determine the overall payment that's been earned by the farmer for producing such a great coffee.
In markets like Africa, corruption is obviously prevalent in all different steps and sizes of harvesting a product. Applying technologies like the blockchain enable us to provide that data so that if there is corruption in the system, it gets rooted out. Providing more transparency to the supply chain is a good thing. We're trying to make sure that the value chain becomes more fair.
And that's really what's driven me over the last 20 years of my career, trying to think of ways that technology can really have an impact in the developing world.